笑，他那个发丝说飞，加多少？把那些小车跑，加多少？对呀。
Right, Aki Kareem for BBTV. We're over at the People's Gym in Heywood. It's good to see Kieran Farrell here with me. And we've got young prospect Emily Whitworth, who's looking great on the pads there, by the way. Kieran, tell us about young Emily. She's looking great there on the pads.
So, yeah, Emily Whitworth. She's a two-time national champion. She's doing really well. And she's worked hard throughout lockdown as much as she could, you know what I mean? And to be fair, she's probably broke through from then. From like, what happened is I had a Amy Timlin spinal tear upper last March or April or whatever it was, when it was the pandemic. And it was just before the pandemic. Or was it? No, it was during the pandemic. It was like May, I think it was. That May time, because the elite athletes could still train. So we went up and done a bit of sparring. You know what? It might have been June, you know. It might have been June.
No, it was in June.
It was June. It was June. Because that's when they could start training. So she come up there. And she was always dedicated anyway, but then I think something clicked with her, and it was her mum said to me, she's like a changed girl, but I've always noticed how talented she is anyway, but she started putting the work in. She doesn't stop. She's like one of them girls who just doesn't stop, you know what I mean? Auntie Fowler texted me the other day and said he used to run 5 times a week when he was amateur, and she said, is that all he used to do? You know what I mean?
Oh, are you loving it then, Emily?
Yeah, I'm really enjoying it, just getting to do like what I love every day. Yeah. And now that I've left school, like, I can do it more instead of having to fit around it, so it's going really well.
That's right, because you just mentioned that you fancy taking on an apprenticeship, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
Staying involved in sports that way.
It's actually just clicked in me. I just remembered now that she sparred with a pro in here. It's not a pro from here, it weren't Amy. It was a pro from another gym. I had to stop the sparring because she would have hurt the girl. And I was like, wow, that's when she was 15. I'm like, she's 15 year old. We've got a Canelo on our hands here, man. You know what I mean? Look, got a Canelo on our hands.
Well, I noticed there you got the speed and the power. And you've got a bit of spite. I can tell a bit of spite in them punches.
Yeah.
Who's your favourite fighter?
Katie Taylor.
Definitely,
yeah.
We've got some good girls coming through. Obviously, we've got Amy Timlin leading the way at the minute. She fought for the Commonwealth title. All the girls have looked up to that. I'm like, wow, we can do that, you know what I mean? So then you got Emily coming through. Then you got Rihanna DeForo coming through. Rihanna was out over in Spain when when Brian Rose fought. She sparred with a girl in an underground gym. That was mad. That was a mad experience. And then, so I actually went out there, made the contacts out there. So I have got a show in Spain, which in a few weeks, what a lot of people know about now. And the two girls are going to box on there. So Emily's going to box on there, and Rihanna DeForo's going to box on there. They're going to box exhibitions, because until you're 16 up there, you can only do exhibitions. So they said, like, look, the girl, they were frightened to death. Like, your girl's going to murder our girls, you know what I mean? Basically, and I'm like, look, put some big gloves and headcats on them, they'll be all right, you know what I mean? So, yeah.
Tell us about the show then, Kieran, because you've also got Sean on it, you've got Jerome, and you've got Connor on it as well. Tell us about this, man.
So, the link up come in March. We was always looking to make contacts out there abroad. We've got a few contacts out there and that, you know, there's a few different people who are putting on the shows and that out there. But I wanted to go out there and I wanted to sit down and see what the crack was, basically, and see what I could do, you know what I mean? Because obviously it's been a write-off over here, the UK. Only the big TV promoters can put them shows on at the minute. And I had the show with Amy Timlin, Carly Skeller, all lined up. For whatever reason, I didn't end up going following it through, but Eddie Earn picked up the fight with, obviously, Caldwell's managing Amy, and that's a really good setup we've got. I've got a good relationship with Dave, and it's good because we can talk to each other, and Dave managed me for my last four fights, so it's actually a really good link up there. And yeah, so I went over there in March. I made contact out there, got over there, Brian Rose fought. We sat down, had dinner, and we said, let's do a show. And basically, everything what I say, I do. So if I don't sit there and talk shit, I'm going to sit there and say, look, if I'm going to say do a show, whether it costs €10,000 or €20,000, let's do it. So we put our plan, put my money up, and been the big boss, mate, and gone and done it, you know what I mean?
And Emily, are you looking forward to boxing in Spain? Because not only you get to box and do what you love and train and be in the gym you love, you get to go to Spain and abroad and get this experience.
Yeah, definitely. I'm looking forward more to fight, to be fair, because it's been like, I'm not boxing since last March now, obviously, because of all the lockdowns and stuff. Yeah. So I'm just like excited to get back in and show what we've been working on.
What an experience, yeah.
She's come on loads through the lockdown, you know what I mean? She's come on loads, like, through that space of time. Like, we've got a little videos and stuff like that from, like, a few years ago where Emily's doing a bit of training and that. And you look at them now and you're like, fucking hell. We actually thought she was good then, but now, she's like been sped up. She's punching harder, you know what I mean. So I'm looking forward to getting the girls out there as well. You know what I mean. Get them fighting out there and seeing what they can do and put it into play. And like I say, that international experience for Sean, Jerome, the two girls, Connor, to get out there. They're all stepping up in the opposition. 6-3s. They got better opponents. They're not fighting just a regular journeyman. They're fighting the guys with the half and half records who are coming to win. So. It's good experience for us all, get out there, and it's just the start of things. It's Vicious Spain, it's a branch, but we're going to branch out in different areas. We've got Vicious Promotions Spain, and we're going to do more shows there. We've picked up some good kids there, there's people out there contacting us now to say we want to be part of it all, and it's going to be a big thing, mate. I know it's going to be a big thing.
How can people watch? Is it on Fight TV like last time?
No, it's not on Fight TV. There will be an announcement nearer the time. Okay. We have got a television thing on board, a television network on board over there, but it's just we cannot announce it yet. We've got tickets to sell and that, so that's what we've got to do, sell them tickets.
And this is great that you're doing this in Spain, and I'm buzzing that you're getting all this traction. Are you going to be, when things are back to touch wood, are you going to put stuff back on it?
We've got shows lined up. Over here, and we'll be busy again, mate. So, like, I don't want to announce any details yet, because we're going to announce that the day after Spain. So, and we're going to go hard, mate. We're going to keep doing what we're doing, picking up these good fighters. Like, I've signed Lou Clay now, signed Brian Rose, signed Jerome Sean. We've got Ben Ridings in the gym, we've got Conor Lynch, Amy Timler, don't want to miss anyone out. We've got some Matt Bailey, we've got Niall Fielding, Niall Berra from Birmingham, we've got Cameron Hussein. There's so many good fighters who we have. I don't want to miss them anymore. Oh, I need to list them all now, don't I? You know what I mean?
It's no offence if you forgot any.
Yeah, no, what happened is, like, Kieran Farrell used to have 30 fucking 7 fighters, and I don't want 37 fighters anymore because I burnt my brains out, mate, you know what I mean? And it's not good for me. So I've scaled back, mate. I've released a lot of fighters. I released Reese McMillan, he's not with me anymore. He just weren't working out. This is sort of since my friend John died. We sort of like, we've come distant, mate. We don't really talk to each other. John was the glue between us, so I released Reese. I wish Reese all the best in whatever he does in the future. I've released Ryan Ibbett, another one. Like, there's no hard feelings with any of these guys. I just need to make sure that I'm doing the right thing, and it's no good me saying, oh yeah, look, Ryan, I'm going to get you a fight, and then not be, like, getting him a fight or whatever, you know what I mean? I don't want to bullshit people. I don't want to be that bullshit manager just to say, look, you're on contract with me for 3 years. Like, it's not working like that, mate, you know what I mean? So, like, I want to just be fair as I can, let him go do the thing, and I want to put my concentration into these sick fighters we've got, because I want to win titles, mate. I'm here on this earth for a limited time. I want to do some epic shit, win some epic titles, some big stuff, and do what we can do, you know what I mean? So that's the big idea, mate, you know what I mean? Just to keep, like, we're all on limited time, you know what I mean? So we need to make sure we do every day do what we love, you know what I mean? And that's what we're doing, you know what I mean? Like, Emily's following suit of what I'm doing. Now, there was people in her ear, oh, go and do this, go and do that, go and do this, go and do that, and I'm like, look, I'm not going to put no pressure on your sister. It is what it is. If you want to go and do that, go and do that, but I'm not looking at how much you can earn in a year. I'm looking at, oh yeah, you can get a fucking 50k a year salary or whatever. Like, fuck that. What the fuck's 50k? Mayweather did fucking 48 mil last night, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Like, Like, it's not a thing, you know what I mean? I'm like, look, you've got to look at the bigger picture, and the bigger picture, we can take life wherever we want to take it. We just got to concentrate, work hard, and keep doing the thing, you know what I mean?
And so that sounds epic. That does sound epic.
I didn't need to do the I just need to be a motivational speaker.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Well, yeah, I mean, look, it's interesting hearing Kieran talk about that, isn't it, Emily? Because that does give you a bit of motivation, and you're around people who are, like, pushing and driving and ambitious. So is that good for you to be around?
Yeah, definitely, like when I came here, like, been 3 years now. I've probably been doing privates like 2 years with him, and then I moved to the gym, and like everything it just changed, like, for me, because I was dedicated, but I wasn't like properly dedicated to it. Like, I wasn't putting work in every day or training 3 times a week, if that. And like when I came to Kieran, it just gives me motivation to do it. You know, like seeing how he used to be, like when he was fighting and. Yeah,
you
know, it's good to be around it.
Yeah, but you know what, mate? I'll be honest. Like I say, it's like when I said about Tex Anthony Fowler for a reason, to show all the kids, because we had kids in here who were not run up that week. I'm like, well, what are you doing then, bro? You know what I mean? What are we actually doing? What are we asked? What am I still there sweating my head off here for, doing pads for you? If you're not going running, I don't want to do that. You know what I mean? I'd rather not. I'd rather just get a day job doing something else. You know what I mean? I want my kids to work hard in here. Like, the kids in here train harder than the pros. And the pros train hard, you know what I mean? So I've got the pros training hard, and these kids I'm pushing to the max. I'm like, look, when you're 15, so like Fowler texted me, like, I did 5 times a week, but I probably, now looking back, should be doing only two or three times, but I'm like, you know what? But you've got to be that ambitious when you're 15 years old to run 5 times, 6 times a week, to then go, right, now I can have a little rest. You're 30 year old now, running 5 times a week is just going to put you in a box. So you run 2 or 3 times a week, but you've already got that fitness ingrained into you. Do you know what I'm saying? So, like, I understood what I'm saying, but, like, they need to be running 5 or 6 times. They need to be doing everything they can. And Emily does. She does, to be fair. She's fit. She spars pros. She spars fucking champions, you know what I mean? And she's not out of place one little bit. She, if anything, they're out of place even with her. And she's not even had a pro fight, you know what I mean? And I know where she can go. We're like, look, if the Olympic dream happens, it happens. If it doesn't happen, we'll go fucking Mexico and get a fight and all that. You know what I mean? Canelo, I'm telling you.
Well, look, no, it's great to see that you got, you know, you've always been full of enthusiasm, but you're still going strong. That's the fire still burning. Sure. And Emily, it's good to meet you. And now I've seen you on the pads and everything, I'm going to be watching you, because got a load of potential there, and all the best of luck in Spain as well.
Thank you.
Kieran, is there anything you want to say, just like anything that people need to know? Regards to this show or anything like that?
Yeah, just more to my own fighters. Look, keep working hard, keep staying dedicated and that. A big shout out to the sponsors, all the sponsors who helped us out. We've got SRM Utilities, we've got Mawson Group, we've got Oxasia Homes,
we've got
Sky.eu. We've got them all, mate. We've got them all, you know, I'm missing them out. The Rendering Company, we've got fucking Sunlight Tanning in Awood. Yeah, they'll give you a tan if you want to get a tan.
Well, I don't need one, but I notice everyone in here looking nice and
today. I'm looking a bit brown, you know what I mean? I always get my whole 5 minutes on the sunbed. Funny joking. Yeah, but no, just big shout out to our sponsors. Everyone's helped us out. You know, we can't do it without anyone's help. And big shout out to all the fighters. Look, if I've not mentioned your name, don't fucking hate on me. I can't fucking remember everyone. And just keep working hard, because, like, shit is happening now. And I'm busy as fuck all the time in here, and at night I go home and I don't think to ring fighters up. Ring fighter for, if anyone's got any problem, they can ring me up, you know what I mean? Give me a bell. Anytime.
You heard it here from Kieran Farrell, BEM.
Yes.
Great to meet you, Emily Whitworth, and see you again next time.
Was
cheers.
It? Power.